Hello, this is Sage reporting for Calkind. Thank you for joining us yet again and a very warm welcome to you. Please stay tuned as we bring you another trending news topic from the world of business and finance. More borrowing and disinvestments in India's 2021 union budget. In summary, India plans to borrow some 12 trillion rupees to meet the capital shortfall. The foreign direct investment limit in insurance has been increased to 74% from 46%. The government would divest in two public sector banks, PSUs, and its flagship life insurance company, LIC. The Indian budget has drawn keen interest not only at home, but also abroad, as people were anxious to know how India plans to address the challenges posed by the pandemic-induced slump. The budget reflects the key areas the government plans to focus on to jumpstart the economy. Earmarking almost $500 billion in government spending, the document gives special emphasis on healthcare, infrastructure, and self-reliance. The government hopes that it will be able to raise a major part of the required capital from increased tax collection, higher imports, levies, dividend income, as well as asset sale. It also plans to borrow some 12 trillion rupees to meet the shortfall. In infrastructure, it is hoped that the government-backed infrastructure investment trusts, or INVITs, would enable speedy execution of projects for road, power, railways, airports, oil and gas, warehousing. Industry leaders have welcomed the measures, saying it will supplement the government's Make in India initiative. In health, a total of 223,846 crore rupees have been allocated for the health sector, which is an increase of 138% of the total 35,400 crore rupees. It'll go towards COVID vaccination and development. More funds will be made available if required in the future. Ms. Sitharaman added, disinvestment and reforms. The government would divest in two public sector banks, PSUs, and its flagship life insurance company, LIC. Changes are expected in the National Company Law Tribunal, NCLT. E-courts will be strengthened and alternate debt resolution mechanisms will be set up. MSMEs and industries. The finance minister has also announced a slew of measures for the recovery of various industries, including the micro, small and medium enterprises sector, MSMEs, hit by the COVID pandemic. In agriculture, assuaging farmers' concerns, the finance minister said that the minimum support price, or MSP, has been increased by nearly 1.5% for various agricultural procurements. India has been witnessing massive farmers' protests in its national capital region against three previous farm acts. Well, thank you for joining us. I hope you found this informative. This is Sage reporting for Calkind.